Thank you, the Honourable Mr. Chairman and all delegates, ladies and gentlemen. Climate change is a sticky topic. We are all filled with good intentions, but execution is a little more difficult. It's a long uphill climb, and we are here today to garner more support to reverse, if not at least contain, our global climate. We have always suspected that global temperatures are on the increase, but it's now official. Year 2014 is the hottest year for many countries around the world. According to one of the world's foremost weather trackers, Japan Meteorological Agency. Because of global warming, extreme climate has become a hallmark of the 21st century. Heat waves and cold snaps, hurricanes and tornadoes, downpours and blizzards form the extreme end of the weather spectrum, affecting our health, infrastructure and livelihoods. Each and every country has experienced the effects of climate change. However, climate change will have a more devastating effect on developing countries as they struggle to cope with the effect of climate change, which will rebound on this country's economy. Right now, on the land we are standing on, Ecuador recognizes that climate change will have an effect on its economy and the population well-being. As a result of climate change, there will be change in water availability and the possibility of more intense floods and drought. It will exacerbate loss of natural habitats, which will leave species facing extinctions and impact agriculture, leading to increased uncertainty in food production and consequently food security. Ladies and gentlemen, my home country, Malaysia, was hit by the worst floods ever in more than two decades, leaving at least 21 people dead and forcing a quarter of a million people from their homes. Extremely high level of flood water and bad weather have made relocating victims and the transport of the food supplies by helicopter difficult. This is expected to impact Malaysia's economy. Even as we speak, assessment and recovery efforts are ongoing, and the Malaysian government is expected to dish out US $217 million in recovery effort. In the last decade, Malaysia has spent nearly US $2.6 billion adapting to more frequent floods. This is money we could have invested in green industries or used to slow climate change. The effect from climate change and the losses resulting from its impact will not abate anytime soon. As long as we keep damaging the environment, we will receive Mother Nature's backlash. While it's difficult to reverse the damage we have created in the first place, what's required is to us to make the initial steps. We are proud to say that our host country, Ecuador, has recognized its vulnerability to climate change. Through the Secretariat for Climate Change of the Ministry of Environment, Ecuador have developed a systematic and integrated focus on the relationship between climate change and economics to propose solutions in the short, medium and long term. In Malaysia, our Prime Minister is fully committed to making a change for the climate so that Malaysia has a more sustainable economy and balanced energy mix. As the Chairman of ASEAN, Malaysia seeks to lead the way in taking steps toward mitigating climate change. We will continue to act to cut carbon emissions through new policies involving climate change and green technology. We stand ready to work with other fast-developing nations to argue for greater ambition in 2015 and to show that economic development and climate action are not competing goals but common ambitions. For this session, not to be another talk shop, I urge each representative here today to wish how each country can contribute to battling climate change. Initiatives could range from promoting climate transparency with a new corporate emissions reporting policy to encourage more clean vehicles onto our roads and rationalizing fuel subsidies. There should be more moves to support public transport with a new mass rapid transit project designed to reduce carbon emissions. Meanwhile, in the construction area, we should be committed to energy-efficient building. I'm proud to say that Malaysia has jump-started this step. Together with that, we are also investing in the startup and entrepreneurs who will make the next generation of energy technology. In addition, we have launched a venture capital fund to finance clean energy projects across Southeast Asia. So, as a man-made greenhouse gases steadily boost the Earth's temperature, the nagging questions become, is global warming to blame? And is there more extreme weather in our future? Sekian, terima kasih. Most gracious, thank you for your attention.
Muchas gracias.